Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to prove the integral from 0 to 1 of x to the x dx is equal to this series. So let's start from this integral. The integral from 0 to 1 x to the x dx. First, we are going to rewrite x to the x as e to the power natural log x to the x dx. Then the next step, we are going to use a property to move the x to the front. And here we have e to the power x natural log x, then dx. Because the right-hand side is a series, so then we think about use a Taylor series expansion. Then here's one. So this is a Taylor series expansion. E to the power t, here's a sum from 0 to infinity, then t to the power n, then divided by n factorial. So then for e to this power, we are going to use this expansion. Let's continue this line. Then here we have from 0 to 1, then here the sum. So then what is t? T for our case just here. X natural log x. So here we have x natural log x to the power n, then divided by n factorial, then dx. So we can switch the integral and the sum. Here, just then we can move the n factorial outside the integral. And here we have n factorial. Then here we have the integral, then x log x to the power n, then dx. Then for the rest of the part, we need to figure out what is this integral. Let's label this one I1. We need to figure out what's I1. So once we figure out the answer, let's put a mark. We are going to put the answer back to this line. Okay, so let's figure out what is the integral I1. Just from 0 to 1 x natural log x to the power n. How to solve this one? So we are going to set a new variable, do a substitution. So let u equal to negative natural log. So and see what happens from here. So then this equivalent to natural log x is a negative u. Then based on definition of a log, so that means x equal to e to the power negative u. Then we need to figure out what's a dx. So dx, just for this one, take a derivative. Just e to the negative u, then negative, then du. We need to figure out what is the lower bound, upper bound for u. So when x is a 0, the lower bound. 0 put here, that's a negative infinity. Another negative, so then u is positive infinity. Then x is a 1, the upper bound. Then 1 put here, so that's just 0. So then u is 0. So now let's put the substitution back to I1. Okay. Let's see. Then here, the lower bound is infinity. The upper bound is 0. So then do the substitution for the inside part. X natural log x to the power n dx. Okay, so then we have here, so this is x log x, then power n dx here, then negative e to the power negative u, then du. Let's simplify here. Let's put all negative ones together. So here is a power n another 1, so n plus 1. And here u to the power n. Then e to the power negative u times n, then minus u. So here's a negative n plus 1 u, then du. Let's take a negative 1 outside, then power n. Because we need to switch the lower bound, upper bound, so we need to use 1, negative 1. So then here so here's the power is n. Here, then we have u to the power n, then e to the power negative n plus 1, then u, then du. So once we got here, we want to do another substitution for this part, for n plus 1 times u. So let's do a substitution. Let the t equal to n plus 1 u. Then solve this one. We have u equal to t over n plus 1. Then we need to do du. So then du here, for this one, take a derivative. It's just 1 over n plus 1 dt. So then as far as the lower bound, upper bound, so they have the same thing. So u is a 0, so t is a 0. So when u is a positive infinity, t is a positive infinity. So they have the same upper bound and lower bound. Okay, so then here, so let's copy the lower bound, upper bound. So then here, the u, this is u. So that's why here, t over n plus 1 to the power n. E to the power negative t. Du here. Then 1 over n plus 1 dt. Then we can take 1 over n plus 1 out. 1 over n plus 1 out. Then here power n, then we have another 1. So power is n plus 1. So now let's see inside we have t to the power n. Then e to the power negative t dt. Okay, so then we need to figure out what's this integral. What's this one? Then here, we think about gamma function. So gamma of n plus 1 is from 0 to infinity, then t to the power n, e to the power negative t dt. Okay, so now let's continue this line, use the gamma function. Then here we have negative 1 to the power n, then 1 over n plus 1 to the power n plus 1. Compare these two integrals, they are exactly the same. So that means this one just gamma of n plus 1. The gamma function has a really important property. When n is a positive integer, so gamma of n plus 1 just equal to n factorial. Okay, so we are going to use this result. So then here we have negative 1 to the power n. Here we have n plus 1 to the power n plus 1. Then this one just n factorial. So that is the reason why at the beginning we set a substitution, let u equal to negative natural log n. Just so here we can use a gamma function, so we can get the result for I1. Okay, so this is the answer for I1. So now let's put this one back to I1, the line we put a mark. Okay, so this is the line we put a mark. Also, this is the original question, x to the x dx. So then we have here just sum from 0 to infinity, then here 1 over n factorial. Here then x natural log x to the power n dx. We label that one as label this integral as I1. So now we get an answer for this one. So we're going to put this one to replace I1. Okay, so now let's put the answer back. From 0 to infinity, then here 1 over n factorial. Put the whole thing here, replace this integral. That's negative 1 to the power n, then 1 over n plus 1 to the power n plus 1, then n factorial. So now you can tell, so these two cancel. So then we have just the sum from 0 to infinity, then negative 1 to the power n, then here we have 1 over n plus 1 to the power n plus 1. So now you see we have the original integral equal this series. Okay. So now let's expand a few terms. First few terms. Okay, so now let's see here. So when n is a 0, so this one positive. So here's a 1. So that's why the first term is a 1. So next term, negative. Then here we have 2 to the power 2. Next one, positive. Then 3 to the third. Next one, negative. Then 4 to the fourth. And keep going. So now you see we prove the identity. The integral from 0 to 1 of x to the x dx is equal to this series. Thanks for watching. See you next time.